We are now in Nice, France, at Urpec 13, where we met Jan Pot, the global key account manager for the petrol station business of Philips Lighting. Jan, can you tell us a little bit more about how this business is organized within Philips?
Yes, of course I can. Thank you for the occasion to explain this. Obviously, Philips is a huge company. Philips is working in basically three, let's say, main sectors, where lighting is one of them, but also into medical and in consumer goods, obviously. Within lighting, Philips is, I would say, on a global scale, active in sectors like outdoor lighting, office and industry lighting, and retail lighting. And if we look at the petrol business for us is a pure retail activity. So within the retail, we see a couple of different account types, if you wish. We see pure fashion accounts like the Nikes and Pimkies and the Louis Vuittons. Yeah, we see the big supermarket chains like the Carrefours, Tesco's, Auchan's. Yeah, as a clear subsegment for us. But a very good one for us as well is the petrol station world as we are living in now.
At the moment, we see a strong trend towards LED lighting at petrol stations. Could you tell us the reason for it?
Yes. Well. LED lighting is not new, yeah? LEDs already exist for a long time. If you think about your cars, yeah, already for years and years we use LEDs in the cars. But over the years, the LEDs became so powerful in terms of light output that more and more we were able to use LEDs also in general lighting, like replacing light bulbs or using lighting in petrol stations. So the reason why we see a trend for LEDs these days is that the powerfulness of these LEDs these days in terms of giving amount of light, where we see it now also more and more into the retail part of our business. It started basically in the outdoor part, where street lighting and canopy lights were already, I would say, profitable from a total cost of ownership point of view. And we see now also that the indoor part of the C-stores, if you wish, is being transformed into LEDs now.
But is it also financially attractive to retrofit from the conventional light to LED lighting?
Yeah, well, already for a couple of years it was profitable enough, yeah, from a total cost of ownership point of view to install LEDs in terms when you had any new build or knockdown rebuild, if you wish. But if we look at the efficiency of the LEDs and the drop in investment costs over the times, we see that 2013 is really a breaking year in terms of retrofitting, whether it's street light, canopy lights, or shop lighting. Then we see in countries where the kilowatt hours are high enough, if you wish, already the best total cost of ownership, definitely.
In what geographical regions are you operating, and what products do you offer in these different regions?
Well, obviously, Philips is a global company. Yeah, we are organized around our clients in the different regions in the world. From history in Europe, we have a strong foothold. We see the upcoming countries or developing countries like Central Eastern Europe being active. So we are active in those countries with all our offices, local offices, if you wish. Outside Europe, then you could think of Asia Pacific, Africa, and America. In America, Philips acquired a big company, which gave us also the possibility to do the business over there now. A specific one is Africa, I would say. Since Africa, we see a lot of development going on at the moment. And Africa, of course, has a lot of sun available. So due to the fact to all this availability of sun, we are supplying solar solutions in combination with our LED fittings in places where there's no grid or in places where electricity is extremely high. So that's a clear new step into technologies for us as well, to give this possibility to have the combination of solar energy together with our LED lighting. In the Far East, if you wish, in China and around China, we see a huge boom in LED technology. Yeah, obviously, there's a lot of suppliers out there. Unfortunately, we're still number one also in that region. And I think that the trend into LEDs will go even faster in the Far East than in Europe these days.